Hello, this is Rev Paul from MiraclesOne, and today I would like to talk with you a little bit about the work that you've been doing with the Workbook for Students. If you've joined with us this year in working through the Workbook for Students, right now you're about a little over a month and a half into working through the lessons with us. And for many of you, you might be discovering or noticing that perhaps you're slipping a little bit, maybe losing a little bit of enthusiasm in your work with the Workbook for Students. You might find that you're not practicing them as much throughout the day, or maybe even forgetting to start off with it in the morning and getting to it later in the day, for whatever it is. So I kind of wanted to acknowledge that, first of all, if that's happening to you, that's normal, and don't feel bad about that. But it is an indicator that it's time for you to sit down and recommit, and to recognize the importance of recommitting and working through the lessons as best you can. We here at MiraclesOne are a community of support that's available to you. So if you're struggling with, let's say you've tried to, you're trying to work through them on your own, but you're kind of standing on the sidelines and watching us through our website or through these recordings and other resources, but perhaps maybe you're struggling a little bit more, I do want to remind you that we have weekly study groups and meetings where we're all getting together online to support each other and to help each other to stay on track and stay focused on working through these together. And also there's a lot of benefits when we join together with others, because as we do our sharing of our experiences of working through the lessons and the insights we gain about ourselves from the Holy Spirit, there's a lot of wisdom that comes through, and it can be truly helpful. So going back to the idea of working on the lessons, and maybe we're starting to lose that enthusiasm, we're starting to see ourselves slipping in the practice, the daily routine. Why does that happen? Well, I think it's like anything else in our lives. We're a lot like animals in a way. We have some cats here that live with us as pets, and every day the cats go through the same routine. They like to do the same things at the same time every day. They're like clockwork, you know, and most of our pets are, especially cats and dogs that often live with us. You know, they will wake you up at the same time every day to either feed them or take them out and do those kind of things. And, so human beings are the same way. We're exactly the same way. We get into these routines that make us feel comfortable, and our bodies and our brains get programmed. The reinforcement of these routines that we do every day that we enjoy get ingrained within our psyche and our personalities in a way. We like to get up at a certain time. We like to take our showers and get dressed a certain way at a certain time. We enjoy having our coffee or our tea or something else for breakfast in the morning many times. And when we go to wherever it is that we work or do our thing throughout the day, you know, there are certain times during the day that things that we like to do. We like to take a break at a certain time. We like to have a lunch at a certain time. And so and we like to exercise, and I could go on and on, but their routines and their patterns and their daily patterns. And right now, as we work through the lessons in the Workbook for Students, we're trying to For some of us, it feels like we're trying to shoehorn something new into our daily pattern, in our routine, and our brains and our patterns, we're not used to it. So there's resistance that goes along with that. And sometimes if we forget why we're doing it, and the importance of developing this particular new habit, then it's easy to start allowing it to slip. And so, like anything else in our lives, when we're trying to develop a new habit, it takes a little bit of conscious effort for a while, and then we start to get used to it. It starts to become a part of that daily cycle. And that's what we're trying to get to here. So when we recognize that's going on, then I think it can make it a little bit easier for us to kind of work through it. And it can be helpful, like I said before, when you're joining with others in a support group to help you with the accountability, to help you with the motivation, to help make it kind of fun. Actually, when you develop a new habit, if you can make it fun, then it's way easier to develop the new habit than as opposed to if it feels like it's a chore. So that's important to keep in mind too. Try to figure out what kind of mindset or what you can do that will help you to enjoy it more. And I've had some recent experiences in my own work with, let me back up here for a second. So you've probably figured out by now that the lessons in the workbook for students, Jesus is gradually leading us down this path where he's teaching us how to meditate. He's teaching us how to go within and begin to become, to connect and become aware of this new spiritual dimension within us that is a very wonderful place once we start to experience it. And right now, we're still learning how to get our minds out of the way, and in the lessons that we're just beginning now, he really, really just started the first meditation type lessons where he's having us close our eyes and we're going within and we're practicing finding this peaceful space inside of us where we begin to have these really wonderful mystical experiences. But keep in mind that our busy minds are still, they're in the habit of getting in the way. They're in the habit of keeping us preoccupied, and we're still learning how to settle those busy minds down, set them aside for a while, and to find this other space inside of us where miracles begin to happen. So it takes practice. And I was reminded of some of the wonderful benefits that come out of the practice once we get into it. So for myself, I recently stepped up my meditation practice, and I've been doing 1 to 2 30-minute meditations every day, once in the morning and once at night. And they're not specifically with the lessons in the workbook for students. They're in a different practice that I'm working right now. But what I've noticed is that in having stepped up that commitment and that desire for positive changes to happen in my life through this practice, that they're actually happening. And I'm experiencing a equivalent step up in my miracle experiences or blessings as I'm going through my days. Over the last couple months, I started this a couple months ago, and it really has been fun and kind of amazing. And I forgot about these wonderful things that happen when we just do a simple thing as just incorporating meditation into our lives. When we go within and we get into that space inside of us where we're connecting with a different spiritual dimension or a different part of ourselves that's in a much higher place with the Creator, things just start to happen. We are not alone, and that is one of the major gifts that comes out of this, because as we go within and we have this intention and desire within our hearts and our minds to experience a positive shift or change in our lives, the forces on the other side, if you will, they are there helping us. They are joining with us in this. And you know, for some of us, it's the Holy Spirit. For some of us, it's Jesus. For some of us, it's both. It can be Buddha, whoever. But there are a lot of positive, there are a lot of helpful spirits and presence out there that are helping us with this process. And as a result of going within and trying, you know, allowing them to help us, positive things start to just automatically happen to us in our lives. And when they happen, they're very joyful, and it's amazing, and it's fun too. And so I want to point that out. Many of you have already experienced this and you know what I'm talking about, but it's a good reminder. It's a good reminder, I think, right now too, for those who might start, who may not be experiencing some of this stuff yet and are starting to struggle. It is well worth it. Now, a lot of people at this time of the year, you know, we just had the beginning of the new year. And a lot of people make New Year's resolutions. And those new resolutions for the year usually involve recommitting and trying to change some kind of habit or experience in your life. You might be trying to exercise a little bit more. You might be trying to eat a little bit less or eat a little healthier. You may be trying to cut back on maybe watching a lot of television. The list goes on and on. But the point that I'm getting at here, there is one thing that, you know, we only have so much time through the day. And also, when we go after to try to make a positive change within our lives, a lot of times just picking out one thing is challenging enough to try to develop the new habit or to make the change. And there is one thing that we can do within our lives that the benefits that come out of it far exceed all of the others, and that is learning how to meditate, which is what we're doing right now. The benefits from just a few minutes of meditation, perhaps in the morning and perhaps at the end of the day, and if you get a chance during the middle of the day, the benefits, the long-term, the immediate benefits and the long-term benefits outweigh all of the other benefits that you would experience from taking the same amount of time and trying to focus that on changing something else in your life. And what you'll notice is, for example, the one thing about the meditation experience and the benefits that come out of that is that when we're first learning how to do it, we may not immediately recognize all the wonderful things that are beginning to happen underneath. And so it might not be as apparent to us, but the practice tends to be a very gentle process of healing and change over time, which is why it's helpful and important to be consistent about it. Because if you're consistent about it, you'll be able to experience the benefits much sooner, and they'll be a little bit more obvious, and they'll and then there's a whole bunch of them. So for example, if you're a type of course student who has already worked through the workbook for students, if you can think about going back to where you were when you first started and recalled the state of mind that you were in back then, your state of mind psychologically, spiritually, and physically as a human being, and compare how you feel at the end of a year or so worth of working through the workbook for students, most of us will find that, wow, there was a definite positive change over the course of that timeline. And many people find that after they've worked through the workbook for students for the first year, they'll continue to work with the workbook for students again and again because of those benefits that they experienced. And I'm talking about psychological healing, physical healing, and all kinds of other blessings that just happen in your life. For myself, years ago, I experienced a lot of anxiety and fear just in my daily walk. And I don't have that as much anymore. I won't say it's non-existent, but I am a more peaceful and grounded person than I ever have been in my entire life. And I know without a doubt it's a direct result of my work in with the workbook for students and kind of bringing me up out, spiraling me up out of the darkness of many years ago of all the luggage and the problems I had with the way I perceived the world and the way I was living my life. And I would never give it up for anything. So we've heard many times, we heard the saying, an apple a day helps to keep the doctor away. Well, meditation is definitely the same way. And now that doesn't mean that if you are working with someone who's a psychologist or a therapist in some manner, and maybe you are using some medications to help you with that, I'm not suggesting that you throw that stuff out the window. But I am suggesting that if you incorporated the practice of meditation, and one way of developing that habit into your life is through the workbook for students and A Course in Miracles, that it will complement your recovery program that you're working right now. In anything that you're trying to change or recover in your life, a positive change. So when we kind of start to experience those positive effects, like I mentioned before, it brings a lot of joy into our lives, and then we want more of it, and it is so cool. And as those miracles experiences become more abundant in our lives, we inherently start to share with them, share those stories with others, and those miracles touch other people's lives as well. Our light becomes brighter and clearer because the garbage has been cleared away. There's been a purification process, and now our lights begin to touch other individuals whose lights are dimmed by the same garbage that we used to struggle with. So now through that gentle work that we've done, we're also beginning to touch and bless other people's lives around us. So, and this is all as a result of just developing this one new single little habit, 10 to 15 minutes, a couple times a day, if you can. It makes such a positive impact in our lives and in other lives, and ultimately in a global change that we're all joining in here, whether we realize it or not, a positive global change. So thank you for your time today. Hang in there, keep practicing. You won't regret it. Take care, bye-bye.